Welcome everyone. In our previous session, we have obtained the condition for the maximum worker. Now in today's session, I would like to start actual Brayton cycle. Actual Brayton cycle and its thermal efficiency. Okay, so let's start our today's session. Okay. As I told you, to understand the Brayton cycle thoroughly, you need to keep 2 to 3 thing in your mind. Okay. First thing, you need to remember PV and TH diagram. Second thing, you need to remember the system layout diagram. Okay. You can say this one is the layout. Okay. Of open cycle gas turbine. In open cycle gas turbine, we have mainly 3 components, namely compressor, then after combustion chamber, and then after gas turbine. Now, air enter inside the compressor and compressor increase its pressure and temperature. Okay. After the compressor, extreme high pressure and high temperature, air enters inside the combustion chamber. Inside the combustion chamber, the high pressure and high temperature air is getting mixed with the fuel where combustion occurs. After the combustion, okay, at point 3, we have extreme high temperature product of air plus combustion. Okay, I mean to say gases, different gases at point 3. Okay, then after 3 to 4 is expansion process in turbine, during which pressure temperature both drop while the volume increase, and finally at point 4, the different product are expanded or you can say thrown into the atmosphere in open cycle gas turbine. Okay. Now based on this diagram, you need to plot TH in the PV diagram, and based on this, you need to derive the correlationship for the thermal efficiency of actual Brayton cycle. Now, how the actual Brayton cycle is different from the ideal Brayton cycle? Tell me, in ideal Brayton cycle, we need to assume the compression and expansion, both process, to be isentropic in nature. Okay? While in actual cycle, okay, we know from the thermodynamic that the entropy during the execution of any process is always increasing. So, in actual cycle, the compression and expansion, both processes are not isentropic in nature. Instead of that, during the execution of both the process, the entropy of the system will increase, or you can say entropy of air is getting increased. Okay. So it is all about the difference between the actual and the ideal cycle. Okay. Again, I would like to recapitulate the difference. In actual cycle, the compression and the expansion process are not isentropic in nature, while in ideal cycle it is isentropic in nature. Okay, both the process. Now to start the derivation, we need to define 2 to 3 parameters here, and that are the isentropic efficiency of compressor, isentropic efficiency of the turbine. Okay. So here, to define those parameters, you need to recall the TH diagram. If you remember the TH diagram for the ideal cycle, you will notice one thing, that the 1 to 2 is compression process, isentropic compression particularly. 2 to 3 is heat addition process at constant pressure. Then after 3 to 4, is isentropic expansion, while 4 to 1 is heat rejection at constant pressure. Okay. Up to this, I think it's clear to all, because this thing we have already studied in our previous lectures. Okay. Now, as I told you, the main difference between the ideal cycle and the actual cycle is that in actual cycle, the compression and the expansion process are not isentropic, but instead of that, it will follow the actual path. Okay, and actual path shows the increment in entropy, or you can say increase of entropy during the execution of process. Okay. So here in this diagram you can say, because of the consideration of the actual cycle, we need to plot here the actual compression and the actual expansion part. So we need to plot 1 to 2 days part like this curvature, which shows the increase of temperature as well as increase of entropy during the actual compression process. Because from the first law of thermodynamics, from the second law of the thermodynamics, we know that during the execution of process, entropy is always increasing, because entropy is the indication of disorderness of the system. So for the actual cycle, it's impossible to consider the entropy remain constant, because during the execution of actual cycle, there are always disorderness of the system taken place during the compression. Okay. So here 1 to 2 days is actual compression process. Similar way, 3 to 4 days is again actual expansion process, which indicate increase of entropy during the expansion. Okay, so here you can say cycle 1, 2, 3, 4 indicate ideal cycle, which follow the asymptotic path. While the cycle 1, 2 days, 3 and the 4 days cycle shows the actual cycle. Okay, clear to all? Now based on the plotting of the actual cycle and the theoretical cycle, now I would like to brief you about the two different terms that are the isentropic efficiency of compression and isentropic efficiency of expansion. So you can say the isentropic efficiency of compression is nothing but the ratio of isentropic compression to the actual work. Now isentropic work you can say is equivalent to mcvt2 minus t1, because from the steady flow energy equation we know that the compressor work is given by the mcvt2 minus t1, because work done is nothing but the enthalpy difference across the device, and enthalpy difference is nothing but mcvt2 minus t1. Okay, so the isentropic compression work is mcvt2 minus t1, while the actual compression work is mcp t2 raised minus t1. Okay, so mcp getting cancelled out, and you will get the isentropic efficiency in term of temperature difference. Okay, as I told you, here I have mentioned some of the process, so you can correlate thing very easily. Okay, just keep this diagram in your mind, and based on this diagram we need to derive some of the equation. Okay, so just keep this diagram in your mind. Okay, as I told you, isentropic efficiency of compression is isentropic work divided by actual work. Okay, so for unit mass I have used this equation. Okay, CpCp get cancelled out from the numerator and the denominator, so you will get the compression work is equal to T2 minus T1 divided by T2 plus minus T1. Okay, clear to all? Just keep steady flow energy equation in your mind. Now, next one is turbine isentropic efficiency, or you can say isentropic efficiency of expansion, which is the ratio of actual work done divided by isentropic work done. Because in actual work done, we need to supply, in actual work done, we obtain the less work compared to the theoretical work done. Okay, so actual work done is nothing but MCP T3 minus T4 less, while the isentropic work is MCP T3 minus T4. Again, it's similar to the compressor work. As I told you that we have to derive the compressor and the turbine work, we need to focus on the steady flow energy equation, because both the device, compressor and the turbine, are the steady flow device, and the for steady flow device the work done is nothing but the enthalpy difference across the device. Okay, so here for the turbine, the actual work done is actual total work done is mcp t3 minus t4 days, while the isentropic one is mct T3 minus T4. And if you consider the work done for the unit mass, then you need to assume m to be 1. So you will get Cp T3 minus T4 is divided by Cp T3 minus T4. Cp is getting cancelled out from the numerator and the denominator. So you will get turbine efficiency like this. Okay. Now, to derive the thermal efficiency equation, we know that the efficiency is nothing but output by input. As the output, we obtain the turbine work done, or you can say net work done divided by input. As the input, we are supplying heat to the combustion chamber. Okay, so compressor work is equal to Cp T2 raised minus T1 for the actual cycle. Turbine work is equal to Cp T3 minus T4 days, while the actual heat supplied to the combustion is Cp T3 minus T2 days. So we have this three equations with us. So based on that, efficiency is nothing but the turbine work minus compressor work divided by the heat supply. Okay, and net work done is what? Wt minus Wc, turbine work minus compressor work. So in this cycle, the net work done is equal to Cp T3 minus T4 days minus Cp T2 days minus T1, that is compressor work, or you can say work input. So, as I told you, the efficiency is nothing but the net work done divided by heat supply. Okay. So, net work done is Cp T3 minus T4 days minus Cp T2 days minus T1 divided by the heat supply, that is Cp T3 minus T2 days. Clear to all? So, it is all about the actual Brayton cycle and its thermal efficiency. Whenever you are dealing with the actual Brayton cycle, at that time you need to keep two things in your mind. First one, you need to consider the expansion and the compression process to be not isentropic. Okay? I mean to say, you need to consider it actual during with the entropy increase. Second thing is that you need to consider the equation of efficiency of compression and efficiency of turbine in your mind, because in number of the numerical we need to use those equations. Okay, so it is all about the actual Brayton cycle and its thermal efficiency. Okay, now in our next class I would like to brief you about the numerical that is related with the actual cycle. Okay, thank you.